have any character recommendations for this type of video, then let me know in the comments below, and I will do that character, and I could do a sequel to this. Now I see Loona Hellhound's phone. Since it is Loona, her phone is usually red, so I'll have to make that obviously red. I have to be really careful not to get her hand or fur color the wrong color, as since she as her hellhound fur color is white and black. Now obviously the outfit's not black, that's a little her shirt, her low cut shirt's usually a little different. So, but you know, I have to keep it that way, since obviously I can't alter I can't modify that color, unfortunately, so I won't be able to change that for show accuracy, but as I said, I'll try to get as accurate to show as I can. Which, those who don't know, Hell of a Boss is a show here on YouTube, which is a spinoff of Has Been Hotel, which will be available on Amazon Prime Video in January. Basically, it takes place in hell, and obviously, Loona Hellhound being a it's basically it's like a hound demon type, you know, thing. That's kind of like a wolf that's humanoid. You know, it's like a human and a human and a wolf hybrid, I guess you could say. You know, the body of a human, and obviously the physical features of a human and speech like a human, but obviously fur and, you know, wolf ears and female natural human female. And obviously the her makeup, since she has, you know, she does the gothic look, so you know, since she has that goth girl look, you know, so I have to make it real gothic-y looking. Her hair is usually pictures more like a gray usually, and since this makeup here is black, I have to do it. I have to make the actual, like, the, not the eyelid makeup, but the actual eyeshadow a different color. Then it'll be too much black and it just won't make any sense. And plus she's got the the eyebrow piercing kind of look, so it helps show that shape. So I'll bring the camera closer in case, because on camera you can see the color a little bit, but just make her eyeshadow a dark gray, like a dark grayish black, so maybe like light black at best, but you know, kind of like a gray. I think it's more of a gray person, I think. See, just coloring some white parts, that way it looks more proper. Obviously, I'm not a girl, so I don't know how eyeshadow goes, because I never used it. So I have no idea. And if you, the closest to makeup I've used is Halloween makeup. You know, since, I don't know if I ever said I discussed it, but basically for Halloween, what I used to do is I used to dress up. I'll have to show a slideshow pictures. I'll have to do it on TikTok. Basically, what I would do is, I would dress up in a costume, mask, and everything, and I would put like black Halloween makeup over my eyes, so I did like just your eyelid and stuff. And to kind of hide it, because I didn't want to know if I had makeup, if I had Halloween makeup, but it was easy to tell I was a person behind the mask. So what I would do is wear a black eye makeup around the eyes and sometimes the mouth area, depending on how the mask was. And it would give the appearance of, like, you would get the appearance of, like a dummy or something, so you wouldn't be able to tell, you know, so you wouldn't be able to see my, my white person's skin. So when you saw the costume, you know, it had that dark jet black look to kind of mimic like a costume, like the dummy costume, the little dummy, you know, like animatronic things you get. It looked like machinery or something, and sometimes I would add a little bit of white and gray to make it look like tubes, to kind of make it look like a machine. So you wouldn't be able to tell that. You thought so. A lot of people actually, you know, fell for it. They thought it was animatronic or a dummy. And so I started moving around there. And people were like, holy crap, that's a real person. It's not an animatronic. That was the funniest thing. Absolute funniest thing. And of course, I used to practice being able to control my breathing so that my breathing would be slower, but also so that, you know, I could breathe so that you can't notice that my stomach is going in and out or my chest is going in and out. So you wouldn't be able to tell I was breathing. I was breathing, obviously. But it was so, I perfected it so good, you couldn't tell that it was a human breathing under it. And it's a technique you can learn. It's just very hard to do. Like, it took me a year to learn it. No. But it's possible. Don't get me wrong. It's possible. It's just, like I said, very difficult. It's really difficult to learn. But it is possible if you work really hard at it and you practice a lot. I mean, I was practicing a lot. You know? So, that's how I naturally how I was able to do it so well. For people, I mean, a lot of people would even say, oh man, I don't have the patience. The people do that, or man, I couldn't even see you breathing. And that's what I tell people, you know, I'm breathing everything else. It's just that, you know, I practice breathing techniques so that it appears like I'm not breathing, to make it so that way when I wear my costume, you think it's an animatronic or a machine, but in reality, it's not. It's a man under a mask. People love that. I mean, people would come back on purpose, and they would tell them my stuff for my mother were there. So they're like, some people would come back because they want me to scare them on purpose, just because. Or they'd have someone in their group and they'd say, oh yeah, I got so and so coming. And when they come, I said, try to steal as soon as you can. And then when they get the signal, try to scare them. Something like that. That was always funny. And we used to have, like, you know, trick or treaters were starting to go down low, but as soon as we did that at my stepfather's house, when we used to, I mean, people the previous years would always come back. Sometimes they come back a couple of times during Halloween. Just to see what I went possession I was wearing, how, or just to see me scare people. It was funny. The funniest thing, like, people loved it. It was like kind of one of those scare trails, as they call it. It was like maybe on like a little Halloween trail, like scary, like that kind of thing. You would see it, like Dorney Park, Great Adventure, or Six Flags, most people know it. Even though it's technically Six Flags Great Adventure, but, you know. Anyway. But, yeah. I mean, we're months, but, you know. I know this particular person, the particular viewer and subscriber, that asked, like, if I still do, Jack Chick, who actually asked about, you know, just to, like, talking ASMR, so I thought I'd add a little bit of rambling in this ASMR. See if you guys like that sort of thing. Well, I color her in for this video. Very carefully. It looks light, but it's darker than what it looks. Like, it looks light because the camera's a little bit higher up. You know, but I'll bring it closer so you can see it. But yeah, I'm just trying to color in the white spots so that way it doesn't, you know, that way it looks as realistic as possible. Get Luna's actual look. Like I said, there's other characters you want me to do. Feel free to let me know down in the comments below, and I'll go through some of the other pages and characters so you can kind of give me an idea of who I got in this book, this particular coloring. And this is a coloring book. I didn't draw this. So obviously credit to the person who, you know, did the outlining and everything else. And the only credit obviously I could take is just, you know, coloring it in, but that's about it. Well, maybe any idea for this video, but that's besides the point. Okay, just like that. Is she her ears? The inside of ears white, so I have to leave that blank. And obviously her white fur. Usually this is more of a, I think this is more of a gray or something like that. I have to look again, but I don't think that's black, but, you know. Like I said, I try to make it as real as possible. Obviously, being that she is a hellhound, which is a form of demon. Obviously, her eyes have to be red for obvious reasons. And the slit cat eyes that she has. It's hard to see, but she has the slit cat diamond. Or as it's usually known as the diamond cat eyes. Which most of the characters from Hellfoss who are demons have that. Well, except for the sinners, of course. Which is basically people. Which in the show they call the ones that they call referred to as sinners. Basically, the humans who oh god, sentenced to hell, but are higher ranking than some of her demons. Since, according to Fizzy Pop, who does the show, clarified that hellhounds and imps were towards the bottom of the bottom of, like, you know, who's higher rank, and usually the hellhounds and imps were at the bottom. I think imps were above hellhounds, or hellhounds and imps are at the same level, but I can't remember. I can't exactly remember. I have to look at it. I saw it on Twitter, not on Twitter, or X, as they call it now. I don't know, I still call it Twitter. Oh, X just sounds like a, I don't know, it just sounds like an adult site name, which I don't like to say X. I just say Twitter. It just sounds more PG, you know? And that's so, like, you know, like adult sounding, if you know what I mean. But there it is. Loona Hellhound. Colored in a coloring book. See, I got that, but that's just miniature things. That's got that of Loona. And season 1, episode 8. Got a Blitz, or Blitz, as he prefers to be called. Moxie and Million Moxie. A baby Moxie with, I think that's Barbie Wire, his sister, and then obviously his mother, which we haven't got a lot, which they haven't done much backstory. And you think they would, it'd be nice if they did, though. Obviously, Ruskin Mayday, who is a succubus, which obviously is more of a, let's just say, sexual demon. Let's just say, I don't want to get too into it because, you know, as a Christian, I don't want to. And just, you know, because, you know, obviously I have younger, not the, you know, the younger audience watches, so I don't want to, you know, get in their head and, you know, tell them what that means. And then next thing you know, they're saying, oh, hey, people, this is what it means and this and that. And da da da. Like I said, I get different characters from the show. There's all sorts of. So that's about it for this video. Remember to like, comment, subscribe. Remember to share my videos. I have some videos.